It's me, MC of Healthy by George. I come every Friday and Sunday talking about all kinds of things that we can do daily to help ourselves age so that we can do things more functionally, both physically and mentally, into our much older years. And truthfully, I would love it if you would subscribe. I truly love the combinations of discussing and sharing about how we can motivate one another to do what we have to do daily to keep ourselves physically, mentally, and emotionally healthy so that we can continue to grow older and do everything that we desire in our lives. So today, I'd like to talk about vision. One of the most difficult things that happens as we get older is that we have a lot of things that go on with us in our vision. I think it's just that the fact that our eyes, the optic nerve, the connection to our brain, the whole processing visually, that this really goes under some slow changes and that we have this natural process that occurs. And sometimes things can signal that there is a greater problem and that we need to get some type of care, medical care. So what are these kinds of problems with our vision? One of the problems that you get around the age of 40 is that our visual lens becomes less flexible and it makes it harder to focus. And so we start to have this change from reading distance or near, and we're going to need sometimes reading glasses. And sometimes this is really challenging. We don't want to use reading glasses. We can't see close up. So we really need to just embrace that our eyes will change. We also get some yellowing. Their lens's clearness gets more yellow as we get older, the tint, which means that sometimes there's a dull color and that their perception, especially around certain hues of blues and greens, can seem a little off. So that's another issue that we have to deal with as we get older. I think the other thing is how we respond to light in our pupils. The issue of how we can see things, our pupils shrink, and we need to react more slowly to changes in light, so our night vision starts to become worse. And so we don't see as clearly as we do at night, as we did when we were younger. And we need more light. As we get older, we just need more light to see as well as we did when we were younger. So those are the two big things. I think the other thing is this issue about being able to detect certain visual distinctions or ability to see clearly and focus. Some of the issues with the rods in our night vision and some of the colors and details can really decrease as we get older. There's also this slowness that happens that we can't switch from brightness or bright sunlight to going to a dark room. Those are other things because we're losing that flexibility in our vision. And these challenging things that we see happening in our eye, and they're common. But there are other problems that can happen, and believe me, I'm learning really hard just through my poor little dog. My dog was recently diagnosed with glaucoma. Now, thankfully for me, thankfully for us humans, glaucoma is not something that comes on so rapidly like it does for these types of dogs. And that was the problem. His pressure in his eye surge to the point of extremeness that caused an ulcer, and therefore he lost his total vision within 24 hours. It was really very upsetting. But glaucoma is something that we as humans also suffer from, and that's why it's really critical to get your eyes checked regularly to get the sense of what is the pressure in your eye that is present so that you're not damaging the optic nerve. This is very troubling because sometimes this can lead to peripheral vision loss, or sometimes entire vision loss. And diabetics sometimes are very prone to eye problems that are really about the nerves around the issues of the pupil and vision. So you need to really make sure that you are seeing your ophthalmologist or optometrist and getting that pressure measured every year so that you can know that you're not at risk for glaucoma, which causes a vision loss. I think the other thing is this issue of macular degeneration. This is where there is damage to the central retina, which is called the macula, and it affects the ability to see sharply. Everything is very blurry, and it just doesn't allow yourself to see clearly. And it's very much age-related, and there's a lot of research being done around macular degeneration. Cataracts. Now, thankfully, we've learned that cataracts, these can be resolved. And you can have the surgery to remove them, and suddenly that lens of your eye is no longer blurry or hazy, and you have clearer vision. So cataracts can require removal if they get really to the point where you are not being able to see clearly. So cataracts are really a concern as well as we get older. Now, as I was talking about diabetic neuropathy, this is a real challenge if you have sugar issues, because what happens is the high level of sugars causes damage to those nerves that go to the retina. And so those blood vessels become damaged, and this can really, truly lead to terrible vision due to diabetic neuropathy. And I know my father suffered from this, and he lost a lot of vision in one of his eyes. I can't remember if it was the left or the right, but it was so troubling to not be able to see clearly. The other issue that goes on is our brain processing. The eyes and the optic nerve is really a piece of our brain. And when your eyes are healthy, even if your brain processing speed is slow, it means that your vision and those processes can be slow as well. So your reaction time, like if you're driving or reading or needing to pick up something, or if you're falling, some of that reaction time is happening because you're slowing down with your brain processing, and so it's more difficult to react in a timely way. So that's really one of the biggest things about our brain processing and our vision. If you stumble, and sometimes when you're stumbling as a younger person, you can catch yourself and keep yourself from falling. But as we get older and you stumble, some of that is very difficult because your reactions are slower. So this is all, unfortunately, part of really aging. So how can we have healthy habits to help us keep our vision as healthy as we can? The key is regular eye exams. And I see an eye doctor yearly, and I'm even considering maybe moving my appointment up because I feel like the vision in my right eye is getting worse faster than my left eye. And so I really may want to go earlier than my normal appointment, which is around October, because I don't feel like I'm seeing as clearly through my right eye as I was when I checked my vision last year. The other issue is protection. The sun is really harsh on our eyes. And while we do want to get sunlight in the eyes early in the morning for our circadian rhythm, we don't want to have sun bearing down into our eyes a great deal. So it is very important to have UV protection, to wear sunglasses if you're going to be out in the sun for extended hours, or wear a hat. Because even if you are wearing a hat, you're going to have some of the sun getting into your eyes, even if you're wearing a hat, because of the reflection from the ground or from other objects around you. The other issue is keep the indoor lighting in your home adequate for you to be seeing. So if you're feeling like, you know, the lighting is not sufficient or you need brighter light, That is really important that you make sure that you have good lighting in your house so that you can see clearly no matter what's happening with your vision. I know for me, I've felt like I need a brighter light sometimes for reading or if I'm doing some kind of small tasks with my hands, I really feel like I need to do it under brighter lights. Other issues is nutrition. Two things that are really helpful for our eyes is to eat rich diet with lutein and omega-3s, antioxidants. These are really key elements for keeping our eyes healthy. We need to avoid smoking and, of course, excessive drinking. These things are really overwhelmingly bad for our eyes. The other issue is related to just our general health, controlling our blood pressure, controlling our blood sugar. All of these things really can contribute to vision challenges. So it's very important that we do what we can to keep our entire self healthy and keep our eyes. Now, there are some things that you can do. There's a couple of practices that you can do with yoga where you rub your hands together and you get a friction, and then you put it over your eyes. This can be very soothing. Or you can do some light massage around your eyes, especially if you feel like you have some tension, and rubbing, or not rubbing, but really patting and gently massaging. These are things that can be very, if you have any kind of stress or strain that you're going through, doing any kind of a light massage or making some friction and putting it over your eyes. Those are some wonderful practices as well that happen in our alternative therapies. So be well, my friends. The key is to keep ourselves as healthy as possible so that our vision, as it declines, we're doing the very best we can to take care of ourselves and to take care of our eyesight. Because really, truly, our vision is key for us to have a healthy and really abundant, thriving life into our older years. So think about subscribing. I'd love to see you here every Friday and Sunday. It's such a wonderful thing to support us or support each other to do what we need to do daily for our health, well-being, and our emotional self as we get older. So see you next time. Bye-bye. So thank you so much for joining me at Healthy by George. I hope you found the information inspiring and that it encourages you on your wellness journey. Because remember, your body, your well-being are a most precious gift. And every tiny action taken daily can make a huge difference. I hope the information here is educational purposes and is not meant to replace your medical care. See your doctor and talk about what works for you. If you enjoyed today's content, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Your support means the world to me, and it helps me continuing creating content that inspires and empowers you to live your best life. Goodbye for now, and join me again at the next Healthy by George.